Hey, Sam here for Guitar Interactive Magazine. Today I'm in the studio with this awesome amp in a box pedal from Tech 21, SansAmp. We've already looked at some of these new Character Plus series pedals from SansAmp. We've looked at the Marshall style one and the Tweed one. And I don't know if Nick's looked at one of the others, but I am taking a look at this other one, which there's four of them in the series. And this is the Mop Top Liverpool. And you can see by the design and maybe the name that it's based on a Vox sound. So that's the kind of classic 60s, 70s sound, everything from Beatles to Brian May and beyond. And within this pedal, you've got two channels and you've got a boost, which is based on the Rangemaster boost, which is a treble booster, very commonly used by many blues rock guitarists from those genres. I mean, Brian May being one person who uses the treble booster as part of the sound, and that gives you a nice kind of cut into the normal kind of classic amp sound, gives you a bit more sustain. So the use of this pedal is to get an amp in a box style thing going on. Now for the review, I'm going direct into the front of a clean amp, so I'm using it like a pedal in front of an amp, but it also has an XLR out on the side, which gives you a matched speaker emulation for the Vox, so it will give you an authentic Vox sound direct. So there's two ways of using that. Of course, it's very small and lightweight, as you can see, and I made the kind of not very funny joke, which was it's the size of a chocolate bar. It's very light and small. You could throw it in your gig bag. You could even throw it in your pocket, and it works on a 9-volt power supply, which it comes with. Nice quality cord there, as you can see, sticking out. So we've got two channels and a boost. So the two channels, when we activate it, we'll see the EQ lights up. This EQ is shared for both channels. However, both channels are voiced ever so slightly differently, and we'll A-B them in a moment. But you've got a volume for each channel, and we can switch between them. And each channel, and this is part of the Character Plus series, has its own character control. And to put it in a very simple terms, it kind of changes the EQ overall of that channel, and I'd say that's a kind of mid-range thing. So you can have a very dark or very bright sound, and that's quite useful to change the character of each channel if you want to use one as a clean, one as a boost, one as a rhythm channel, etc. Each channel has its own drive control. On channel A, it's going to be a bit lower gain. On channel B, it's a bit more pushed. But of course, we can go from very classic tones, and with the use of the boost, we can take it to the next level. So let's just hear my basic tone here with just channel one on the Mop Top Liverpool. And we're going to leave everything about midway so you can get an idea of the kind of default setting. Here we go. So very kind of classic, British sounding, very mid-range focused, a little bit broken up there. If I boost the volume a bit and bring the drive down, we might get a bit more of a cleaner tone. Now using the character control for that channel, we'll change the kind of mid-range EQ. So I'll hold an A5 chord and I'll just kind of sweep the EQ as we go. Taking that further, let's just hear what the kind of drive we can get from that channel without a boost, see what the maximum gain sounds like. So straight away, this is the classic Vox kind of sound. I'm hearing into my ears the kind of Brian May, kind of very warm mid-range, but also cutting sound. So with that being said, let's just use channel A as our boost channel. We're going to boost it with the Rangemaster now. Now the Rangemaster has these two extra controls. It has a high shift and a mid shift. And these work quite interestingly with the actual boost level, which is there. Now, I'm going to have these shifts turned off. We're just going to engage the boost and just to hear how that sounds. And without those two on, it just works as, you know, when the level goes all the way up, you're getting more boost, and when it's down, less boost. Here we go. So back to our original. Boosting. Let's turn that boost up all the way. So immediately that gives a bit more compression in the front end because it's pushing the front of the vox here, which is what the range master was meant to do, giving you more sustain. And it also gives a nice EQ to the tone. Now, more commonly, if we use the high shift button, we press that, then when the control is behind anti-clockwise from 12, then that works as a kind of treble. You get a bit more treble kind of frequencies come in. So if I take that from just about 11 a.m., get this. So right there, that's giving us a 12 dB boost in that kind of higher frequency. Let's just crank the amp a little bit, see if we can get a little bit more of a May-esque tone. That's lovely. It gives you those emulation of those little harmonics that come through. Quite a nice touch. Obviously, none of this is a replacement for the real thing, but the real thing, the real Brian May sound is nine, or I don't know, six amps. I don't know how many, lots of big amps on stage. This fits in your gig bag. So pretty cool. The mid shift works in a similar way, but when it goes clockwise from 12 o'clock, we get a different kind of mid range come in. And on the website for SansAmp, it says this gives us apparently a bit more of a modern characteristic to the tone. So let's use our ears and find out. So I'm going to flip to mid-shift, play an A5 power chord. So quite subtle to my ears, but it's a different type of range going on there. I wonder if it does anything else when you go backwards. Okay, so it must work in the same way as the first one then. My bad. So let's turn the boost off for a moment. I just want to demonstrate the EQ because the EQ is pretty interactive because you want it to be, especially if you're going direct. If you boost the high end quite far, I'm just going to keep so obviously this is working in conjunction with the character control. So these EQs are going to be really important in terms of getting the maximum amount of potentiality out of the sound. So it's not going to be working like a classic amp EQ, it's just going to give you more control over the tone completely. So if we take some drive out, boost the volume, take some low out, add some treble, and then bring the character up, we might get a clean tone. Let's see if we can get a nice clean tone going on. Thank you. So you can get those kind of jangly cleans that the Vox can also do as well. So there's plenty there. Now I haven't gone to the other channel yet. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna reset everything to noon, midway, and then we're just gonna A-B the channels A and B just to see if there's a difference in terms of the tone. Here we go. Now, to my ears in the studio, I don't really hear much difference between them. So it does seem like that you can use that. If I change the character of channel B, for example, to more mid-range and maybe bring back the character on channel A. So channel A. That might be a basic kind of way you might set things differently to make sure that you've got an option to go between two channels. But mixing those two channels with the boost, it's very versatile. There's lots of sounds you can potentially get out of that. So far we've been going through the front of the amp. I'd be interested now to try it out direct out through the XLR, and we'll just A-B those channels again to see if there's any major difference in terms of how it sounds. Let's go. Over to channel B. So as we can hear, the cabinet emulation is pretty cool coming out of the XLR. Very useful for those gigs where you just want to turn up and plug in and you get some monitors or maybe some in-ear monitors. Or maybe you want this in front of your amp, but then you want to send out the DI of the XLR to the front of the house to get a cleaner signal out of the front of the PA. So you can use this in many different ways. So those two channels are very kind of similar again. Maybe that there's a little bit more difference actually, to my ears at least. Maybe you can let us know what you feel if there's a difference there. I'm going to now dial in the boost here, just get a bit more of a leady tone. I'll put the high shift on, bring that back, character back a little bit. Bit of high, take out the lower bit and a bit of mids, and here we go, see how this sounds. So to my ears, that's got like very glassy tone. With the DI out, I think the more of the actual character, not to use a pun because it's a character plus, the character of the Vox is a lot more appropriate. It's going to sound more like what they're going for versus using it in front of an amp. So to my ears, that's probably how it's intended to be used most of the time. But I think the tones that come out of this in both scenarios are very usable and very inspiring to play through. So that's the Mop Top Liverpool, part of the Character Plus series from Tech 21. SansAmp, they've always made these great DI pedals for bass players and guitarists. And with the way gigs are going for most professional musicians, if you're doing lots of kind of silent stage work, these things are invaluable, really useful. And especially if you're flying out to do gigs as well, or you're having to travel light, or you want a backup, these kind of pedals are really useful. So I'd highly recommend checking out the Character Plus series from SansAmp. High quality company, good track record, and fantastic. So that is the review. I've been Sam Bell for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and we'll see you soon.